Hello again and welcome to the reaction video of Ningen Isu and their cover of King Crimson's 21st Century Schizoid Man. So this song was requested by Aki H through Patreon. Thank you again for your support and thank you for suggesting this music. So Ningen Isu, I never heard them before. They are Japanese hard rock, heavy metal, doom metal, progressive rock band. I read a little bit about them on Wikipedia. They are apparently hugely influenced by Black Sabbath and also by Robert Fripp, and they've been making music for a long time, and this is actually an old recording of their cover of 21st Century Schizoid Man. Which brings me to the song I already heard. I know this song, 21st Century Schizoid Man. I did a reaction actually. Had a couple things wrong. It was missing the middle solo because of the YouTube copyright issues, and I did a blunder. I pronounced Schizoid wrong. Come on, man, pull your shit together, English. Why don't you have just a K instead of a CH in the fucking word? It's a K, it's pronounced like a K, just have the goddamn letter K in it. God damn it. God damn it. Sometimes English just pisses me off because of just the unlogical nature of how sometimes words are written down, man. That's why I love Slavic languages and my own language, because every letter is pronounced the same no matter the word it's used in. God damn it. Okay, I'm a little heated up right now, but let's go and listen to Ningen Isu. So the quality of the video isn't the best because of older video. Like the HG guitar. Very similar vocals. Great, great vocals, like them. They're very similar to the actual. This riff in this song is incredible. I like the guitar though. I wish it was actually a hard part, you know. It has a nice drop on it. So far it seems very, very faithful, the actual song. Baseline send. fucking jobs, man. Baseline, yeah, can't go over the baseline. Now, I'm not completely sure how faithful the solo was. I did hear this in the song, the original, before doing this. I don't think it's completely the same. It's gonna be tough without actual beat behind it on the side. Very full sound, especially considering there's only three members. Love the drum kit. When you try to fake a solo, that's how it sounds like. Very impressive cover, especially considering that the guitarist did only the kind of the saxophone parts, at least most of them that he could fit in when there wasn't a guitar. So that was very impressive, all the kind of the solos, the solo work in the middle of the song, which was supposed to be a saxophone, but it's actually the guitar. The drummer is fantastic as well. Nice drumming, great feels. The bass, great sound to the bass. And in general, the whole kind of sound is good. I just wish it was higher quality, because the guitar has kind of this rough sound. I believe it's just SG with a Marshall amp, which makes sense. They're kind of influenced by Sabbath, as I said, that they would have an SG. And yeah, very impressed by the guitar player's ability, and also the vocals by him. They're very, very similar to the actual original vocals on the studio version. Sounds fantastic. I would actually be interested to hear one of their actual songs, their own original songs, because I'm interested what that inspiration by Black Sabbath means, or influence by Black Sabbath, I mean to say. I know I'm interested in that, but otherwise, yeah, great show of musicianship, I'm impressed, very nice cover, and yeah, I don't feel like talking about this song again, I did a reaction to it, go check that out, even though it's missing the middle part of it, I believe, but still, majority of it is still there, and yeah. If you enjoyed the video, like, comment, and subscribe, always helps out, and yeah, see ya.